This has been a very big first year for me here in Cape Girardeau, and I have immensely enjoyed my time here so far. It's just been amazing. I get to work with some amazing men and women in the police department. I've said this to other people before, the organization I came from had some very professional police officers. These guys would run circles around me. Please don't send this back home. One of those amazing people was Roger Fields. You know, Roger, when I first got here, he was my right-hand guy. And he showed me the ropes, told me the things I needed to know, and then we lost him earlier this year. And that was a big, big void in our department. It was a big void for us, and it really hit us hard, and we're still recovering from that. But I can't say that without saying that I had some incredible guys that stepped up to the plate. Jack Wendt, Buddy Davis, and several others that just really got us through that time. And, you know, can we just give those guys a round of applause? We couldn't have made it through that time without the hard work and dedication and compassion of guys like them. This year we did some realignments. We kind of realigned our structure a little bit, moved some things around. We actually had 12 promotions this year, which is almost unheard of in an agency our size. But because of some retirements and Roger's death and things like that, that gave us the opportunity to promote some outstanding guys into some positions, and you'll see them more out in the field and in their roles as lieutenants and over the patrol division and all that. And every one of them took that job with enthusiasm and hit the job running the ground running, and I couldn't be prouder of the work that they're doing. We've had some difficulties also, though. We have experienced quite a bit of violent crime. Thank you to KFVS for always being sure to cover every time something bad happens. I thought when I gave Kathy my cell phone number, it was just so that she could invite me to the local neighborhood barbecues, but that's not usually what she calls about. But along with that, there are a lot of myths out there that exist with that too. You know, people say that we've had lots and lots of shootings, and we have. We've had more shootings than we should have. Nationally, we've had more shootings than we should have. It's not exclusive to Cape Girardeau. But we haven't had more shootings than what we normally have had. We ran the stats just the other day. In the last 6 months, we had 20 just shots fired calls, confirmed shots fired calls, and 10 of those with people being hit. But if you compare that with the last 6 months, the same 6 month period in 2013, we had 24 shots fired calls with 6 people hit. So we're not trending upward, which is a fortunate thing. Yeah, one of the things that frustrates me probably the most is when people say, well, I don't know that Cape is safe anymore. Well, that frustrates me because, one, I take that personally because I feel like it's my personal responsibility to make sure that Cape is safe. And I will tell you that Cape is safe. I won't say who, but I was told of a service organization that said that they won't even send their workers to South Cape anymore because they're not safe. That discourages me because I have not seen a service worker shot in the city of Cape Girardeau ever. And for them to say that really, really discourages me. And my answer to that is my wife every morning gets up and drives to Jefferson Elementary School unarmed to teach third graders. And often she stays late and works at the school late and does her lesson plans for the next day or attends events at the school. And I don't for a second worry about sending her to that. Not for a second. So if I'm not worried about it, about my own personal family, I don't think anybody else should be. Cape is a safe place. I'll get off my bandwagon on that. Tell you some of the things we have done. Thank you. We started a street crimes task force this year. We realized that there was potential for crime to really ramp up. We were seeing some trends in our drug dealing and some of the gang activity that circulates amongst our city, Sykeston, Poplar Bluff, Charleston. So we got together and decided we would implement a street crimes task force. We've run about 9 operations over the summer with that, 5 of them here in Cape Girardeau. As a result of that, we've arrested and taken off the streets 46 criminals. I think that's significant. That's not something that we could have done alone. That is the cooperative spirit of Southeast Missouri and law enforcement in Southeast Missouri working together, all the agencies coming together and saying, we recognize the problem, and we're not going to be selfish and just hold our resources in our city, but we're going to work together and get rid of that. And I think it has made an impact. I know some of you haven't liked the helicopter flying out overhead on Friday night and you're trying to barbecue out on your back patio, but that's just part of the deal. By the way, with the helicopter, we can actually see what you're barbecuing on the grill, too. Some of the other things that we've done is we've taken officers and we've deployed them on what we call directed patrols. We constantly monitor our crime stats, and when we see that we have an area that's maybe starting to become a hot spot, we'll take a group of officers, 5 or 6, and just flood that area and take more or less a zero tolerance approach to that. And I think that's gone a long way for reducing a lot of the crime problems that we've had. But really what's most important for reducing crime in our community, or any community for that matter, is partnerships. And that's where I think that we excel, as the Cape Girardeau Police Department partners with its community. Because it is our community. A lot of us live here in this town. I think probably half of the officers grew up in this town, so they have a dedicated commitment to making this a better place. And we're truly committed to being a partner with our residents, with our businesses. It's important to us that we all work together to make Cape a safe place. Some of the ways that we do that is we've kind of ramped up our social media effort a little bit. We put a lot of information out on Facebook, we put a lot of information out on Twitter, and if you'll see there's on your table, there's some little social media cards that have our Twitter and Facebook addresses on that. So if you haven't started following us on Twitter or following us on Facebook, do so. Please do so. We're even in the process of expanding our efforts in that area as well. And when we put out crime information on that, we put out important stuff that you need to know right then. But we also use that to solicit your help too. Sometimes if we're looking for a particular person, we may throw a video of them up on Facebook and ask for you to help us find that. And we use it as a way to personalize our officers a little bit. We'll put fun things on there. I made my staff wear Texas Rangers gear earlier in the season, and we put that picture on Facebook. I'm sorry about that again. I avoided the whole ice bucket challenge thing until Kim and Tim Ingram publicly challenged me, so we put that on Facebook as well. Thank y'all for that. And I will pay that back. We want you to follow us on that. We want you to partner with us on social media. This year we did a national night out. We partnered with Target and set up a bounce house in their parking lot and invited kids from the community to come out and just crawl around in our police cars, get to know our police officers. And we had over 80 kids show up for that. It was a great event. And that's just the beginning. We're hoping to branch that out and start doing that in neighborhoods, because national night out is about getting out in your neighborhoods, meeting your neighbors, having a potluck on your street, in a bounce house, barbecuing some hot dogs or brisket or something, and getting to know your neighbors and getting to know the police officers that work in your neighborhood. So next year you'll see that even in a bigger form. It won't just be in the parking lot of Target, but we'll start branching out into neighborhoods. And that's just such an important thing, because then you get to know us, we get to know you, and you get to know your neighbors. And that's really what reduces crime, is neighbors looking out for each other. In addition to that, this last month we hosted our first Coffee with Cops. The goal was to have people come by, we would buy you a cup of coffee, and you just chat, talk about something that's important to you. We were going to work from 8 to 9 at that and drink coffee, and we ended up not leaving until, was it about almost 10:15, 10:30, because people just kept coming. And that's awesome. That was a great opportunity for our officers just to sit and have a casual conversation with somebody and talk about real issues that are really important to them. And so often, we come at somebody's worst day, at somebody's worst time, and it's always conflict of some kind when we arrive. So we don't get that opportunity to just sit and talk about what's important to you. Even if it's just an officer and somebody else talking about their kid's soccer, that's such an important thing because it builds those connections and it builds those bonds. I think we had over 70 people show up for our first Coffee with a Cop. We're going to try to do those once a month, and they're going to be all over town. And if you follow us on Facebook and Twitter, you'll see when the next one is. But we're working on getting that rolled out pretty soon. Another initiative that we've taken up, and it's not just the police department, it's a citywide initiative, is a neighborhood development initiative. And really the goal of that is to work with people in impoverished areas or areas that may be suffering from a little bit of urban blight or maybe have high crime. But to work with those people and help them feel empowered to take their neighborhoods back. If the community takes their neighborhoods back, one, it makes our job much easier, but it makes the community a much better community. We had our first meeting a couple of weeks ago on a Saturday morning with some community leaders on the south side of Cape, and I went in expecting relatively positive results. I walked out with beyond positive results. It far exceeded my expectations. We had a community that said, here are what our real issues are, here are the needs that we have, and we're going to take some steps on our own to correct those needs. And we want to partner with the police, we want to partner with the city, we want to partner with our business community to make our neighborhood a better neighborhood. And it all just started from a conversation. We just sat down and we talked. One of the things that they said was really important to them, and this will help us as well, is when we have a very serious crime, and again, this is not just the Cape Girardeau issue, this is a nationwide issue, people don't want to talk because they're scared, they're worried about retaliation against them, but for whatever their personal reasons are, it's very difficult sometimes to get people that have information about a crime to come to us and talk to us about a crime. Our first meeting of this neighborhood development initiative, one of the things that came out of that was that the community said, we want an anonymous way to report stuff to the police department. Well, that's a great idea. So next week, we're rolling out an anonymous phone line. We've started working with a vendor to do an anonymous text line so that people can text tips and they can text video, they can text photos of something that they see, and it's completely anonymous. And you'll see more of that if you follow us on Facebook and Twitter. If you see a thing here, follow us on Facebook and Twitter. You'll see more of that as we're rolling that out. But that was a great idea, and it wasn't our idea. That was a community idea, and we said, you know what, that's an awesome idea. We're going to take it, and we're going to run with it. One of the other ideas that they had was they'd like to see more cameras in their particular neighborhood. That's a great idea. We're doing some research on that now to see how we can effectively roll some of that software out and technology out for our crime prevention efforts. One of the other things that we're working on is we are in the process of researching body cameras for our police officers. We've all seen the events in Ferguson, and it's been a real push for body cams nationwide. We were already working on that. I think you probably saw a story not too long ago that we were testing some body cameras. We're still in that testing phase, but we're hoping that once we find a funding source, that we'll roll those out. And what that does is, one, it's great for evidence purposes, because now it's captured on video. People typically will tend to behave better if they know that they're being filmed. And it holds us accountable, and that's what we want to be. We always want to be transparent. We always want to be accountable to the community that we serve. And that's another way that we can show that we're transparent and that we're accountable to you, our community. And then the last thing that we're working on is we're looking at options of rolling out like an online reporting, where if you have a minor crime, not that any crime is really minor when it's happening to you, but a crime that you just need a police report for maybe, or that if you really don't want to wait around for an officer to come to your house to take your report for you, we're working with some vendors and researching a process of doing online reporting where you can go to the internet, you can go to your computer, and you can do your police report just like that, and then it gets assigned up from there. And we're hoping that will free up some officers' time if they can spend more time in their neighborhoods, patrolling their neighborhoods. And so Kim can't airborne me, so I don't even know if I'm close to my 15 minutes, but I'll wrap it up because I know everybody needs to get back to work. This has been an amazing year. I can't express enough how thankful I am that I and my family have gotten to Cape Girardeau. This community in this last year has embraced us like we've been here forever. The department has embraced me, which is, if you don't know, that is a very huge thing for a chief to come in from the outside to a department of a bunch of people who he doesn't know and they don't know him, and to actually be welcomed is huge. And I haven't for a second felt unwelcomed by my officers. It's been such a great transition, and I think that speaks to the quality of people that are in Southeast Missouri. This is a great place, and we as your police officers are committed to keeping it a great place and to making it an even better place for all of us to live and work and play in. I know people have got to get to work, so I'm not going to take questions right now, but I will be around. If you have a specific question, you can come up and catch me before I get out the door, and I'll answer your question. Or you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter and see what the next copy of the cops is, and you can come there and ask a question as well. Thank you all very much.
Their annual auction, Hudson's Auction, and so if you haven't got a ticket, you might want to come and enjoy that evening and maybe get yourself some. Our first sponsor today is Big River Telephone, and I invite Chris Besky to come forward.
Kim, have you had to use that before?
Well, I mean, no. Today, this is the first month we've implemented it, so.
Maybe I'll get to be the first one.
Yeah.